Concurrency control is the mechanism or the management procedure that is required for controlling concurrent execution of the operation that takes place on a database. But before going to the concurrency control, we must understand how concurrent execution of the transaction takes place in the database. Basically, in multi-user system, multiple users can access the same database at the same time, which is known as the concurrent execution of the database. It means that the same database is executed simultaneously on a multi-user system by different users. You can take an example of withdrawing money from an ATM center. There are thousands of ATM centers of, say, ICICI Bank. Many people using the same database, account database. So it is possible because of the concurrent execution of the transactions. While working on the database transactions, there occur the requirement of using the database by multiple users for performing different operations. And in that case, concurrent execution of database is performed. So this is the requirement that happens always when many users want to access the database at the same time. Why we do concurrent execution in the system? There are only two advantages of it. That is to increase the throughput of the system, and second is the average response time given by a system to the transaction. It should be reduced. So there is always a reduced average response time for each and every transaction that is happening concurrently. Then the third point is the thing that is the simultaneous execution that is performed should be done in an interleaved manner, and no operation should affect the other executing operation, thus maintaining the consistency of the database. Thus, on making the concurrent execution of the transaction, there occur several challenging problems that we need to resolve. Now you must understand, what do you mean by interleaved manner? This a number of transactions are happening concurrently in interleaved manner. It means they do not interfere in between other transactions. Even if they run concurrently, we can change the sequence of the instructions of the transactions by swapping of non-conflicting instructions, the way we have studied in conflict realizability. That is possible. Interleaved manner means they can be swapped, their sequence can be changed. But while doing this, there are many problems occur. That is, the first problem is, the three different types of problems happens when we execute the transaction concurrently. In database transaction, we focus mainly on only two operations, that is read and write operation. So there is a need to manage these two operations in concurrent execution of the transaction, as if these operations are not performed in an interleaved manner, and the data may become inconsistent. So the following problems occur with the concurrent execution of the operation. If you do not handle this properly, then there will be definitely an inconsistency in the database. Now, to understand the first problem, is loss update problems. It is also known as write-write conflict that happens in between two transactions happening concurrently, and they are working on the same database or same data set or on the same data item. The problem occurs when two different database transactions perform the read or write operations on the same database items in an interleaved manner, that is concurrent execution, that makes the values of the data items incorrect, hence making the database inconsistent. or it leaves the database in an inconsistent state. To understand this, we'll see one example here. Consider there are two transactions, TX and TY, are performed on the same account A, where the initial account balance of account A is $300. The initial balance is $300 in account A. Let us see different instructions that are given in this particular schedule. The first instruction is by transaction TX on account A is read A operation. It means you are reading the balance of account A, and it can be considered as time T1 this particular instruction has been executed. Or you can also number this as instruction numbers, right? Instruction 1, 2, 3 and so on till 7. Or you can mention T1, T2, T3, T4 and so on. So T1 is the time at that particular time this particular instruction has been executed in the system, that is read A. Then at T2 we have another instruction, that is A equal to A minus 50. At T3 we have another instruction in transaction TY, that is read A. In T4 we have A equal to A plus 100. T5 there is some another operation that we are going to do here. In T6 we want to update the account balance in transaction TX in account A. And at last, the last instruction is write A operation by TY transaction. These are certain instructions given in this particular schedule. So at time T1, what is happening? At time T1, when I perform read A operation, it means I am reading the balance of account A. So it will going to show me $300. So it is just reading the balance of account A. So it will show me it is $300. Then in time T2, I am executing a statement, that is A equal to A minus 50. When you do this, it becomes $250 only deducted but not updated in account A. So till now we just deducted it from the account A but not updated in account A. It means still if you check the account balance of account A, it will show you $300 because it is not updated. It is just a temporary action that we have deducted 50 rupees from account A. Then we have another statement, that is T3. At time T3, we have another operation. At T3, we are performing read A operation in transaction TY. So here if you see, at time T3, in transaction TY, the value of account A, that will be again $300 only because TX did not update the value yet. It means the value was not updated by TX transaction. Before that, TY read the account balance of account A, and there it will find the account balance of account A is $300. Then at time T4, we are adding $100 into account A. So if you do that, the account balance will be $400. This time we only added but not updated till now. So it means that both the transactions have performed something but they have not updated the account A. So at transaction at time T6, transaction TX writes the value of account A. If you see here in the above table, at time T6, transaction TX perform write A operation on account A. It means that at time T6, the value of account A will be updated as $250 only, as TY did not update the value yet. It means that if you see in transaction TY, you added $100, but it is just added but not updated, or it is not written into the database. Before that, TX perform write A operation. So it will going to subtract $50 from initial balance, that is 300, and updated balance of account A will be now $250. And then the last statement of our schedule is write A operation by transaction TY. Let's check what will happen now. Similarly, at time T7, transaction TY writes the value of account A. So it will write as done at time T4, that will be $400. It means the value written by TX is lost. That is $250 is going to be lost. Hence, that data becomes incorrect and the database is set to inconsistent state. It happened because both the transaction read the values, initial values of account B. In between, some updated, and later on another transaction is updated the account A. And this problem is called as lost update problem, and it happened because of write conflict. So it happened because of write A operation by TX and write A operation by TY. Let us understand the second problem that happens due to concurrent execution of the transaction, due to concurrency. That is called as dirty read problem, and it is also known as write read conflict. It occurs whenever both the transactions perform write and read operation on the same data item. So here, to understand this particular problem, again we are going to see one example. Before that, we'll see what do you mean by dirty read problem. This problem occurs when one transaction updates a data item of the database and somehow the transaction fails in between, and before the data gets rolled back, the updated data item is accessed by another transaction in the system. There comes the read-write conflict between both the transactions, and because of that, the dirty read problem occurs and the updated value will be read by some another transaction. To understand this, we'll see again a schedule having two transactions TX and TY. Again, initial balance of account A is again $300. See, there are five instructions into this particular schedule. So at T1 time, we are going to read the balance of account A in transaction TX. At time T2, we are going to perform addition of $50 into account A. And then at time T3, we are going to write the account balance A. So we are going to update the balance of account A at time T3. Then transaction TY reads the value of account A. And at time T5, suppose the server goes down and the rollback operation is executed, then what will happen? We'll see step by step. Here's the dirty read problems comes into the picture. Let us see and understand how this dirty read problem happens into this particular schedule. At time T1, transaction TX perform read operation on account A. So there it will get the account A balance as $300 initial balance, right? then $50 will be added at time t2. So you can see here at time t2, $50 is account added to account A, and that becomes $350. At time t3, we are going to perform write A operation on account A by transaction tx. So the account A's balance will be updated to $350. At time t4, we are going to read account A's balance. That's why in transaction ty, when you read the account A balance, it will now say read the updated balance of account A, that is $350. But at time t5, because of some problem like hardware problem, server goes down, and that particular transaction gets failed. Tx gets failed. Then at time t5, transaction tx rollbacks due to the server problem, and the value changes back to the original value, that is $300. Whenever the transaction gets cancelled, the database is set to the initial state. So again, your account balance of account A becomes $300. But the value of account A remains $350 for transaction TY as committed, which is the dirty read, and therefore known as dirty read problem. This particular problem is called as dirty read problem. So you can see this particular schedule and the instructions given into the schedule. Due to some problem, transaction A TX gets cancelled, but in between transaction TY read the updated value of account A, which was produced by transaction TX. So whenever such things happens into the database, the dirty read problems occurs at that time. Have you understood, student, what do you mean by dirty read problem? Please reply in the chat box. Have you understood what is dirty read problem? This question may be asked for 5 marks in the exam. Okay. There is one more problem. Because of the concurrent execution of the transaction, the third problem is, I'm going to share this PDF with you for your reference later on. But right now you understand what are the different problems that will going to occur because of the concurrent execution of the transactions. We have seen first problem, that was loss update problem. Second problem is dirty read problem. And third problem is called as unrepeatable read problem. It occurs because of the write read conflict between two transactions, also known as inconsistent retrieval problems, that occurs when in a transaction two different values are read for the same data item. To understand this, again we'll see one example of a schedule having there are two transactions TX and TY. Initial balance for account A again is set to $300. There are again 5 instructions here. At time t1, we are going to perform read A operation in account transaction tx. At time t2, we are going to read the account balance of account A in ty transaction. At time t3, ty transaction update add $100 into account A. At t4 time, it performs the update operation on account A by ty transaction. Then at time t5, transaction tx perform read operation on account A. Now let us understand what do you mean by unrepeatable read problem here. At time t1, transaction tx reads the value from account A, so it will get the balance of account A as $300. At time t2, transaction ty perform read operation on account A, again it will get the initial balance of account A as $300. At time t3, it will going to add $100 to it, so the value goes to $400. At time t4, it will update that value into the database, so the value of account A becomes $400. Now at time t5, again tx transactions perform read operation on account A, So TX read the initial the updated balance of account A now, and it will get the value as $400. It means that within the same transaction TX, it reads two different values of the same account A, that is $300 initially, and after updation made by the transaction TY, it reads $400. It is an unrepeatable read and is therefore known as the unrepeatable read problem. So have you understood, student? Here in the same transaction we are reading the value of account A more than one time, and if you get the different values for the same account, then this problem is referred as unrepeatable read problem in the database. Thus, in order to maintain the consistency in the database system and to avoid such problems that takes place in concurrent execution, the management is needed, and that is where the concept of concurrency control comes into the picture. So we are going to now see, to tackle this problem, what are different protocols are there in database system. Okay, before that, going to the concurrency control protocol, let me know, have you understood all the three types of problems happening to the database system due to the concurrent execution of the transaction because of the concurrency? Have you understood all these three problems? The first problem was lost update problem. It has happened because of write-write conflict. Then we have seen the alternate problem, which happened because of write and read conflict. And we have seen the last problem, that is unrepeatable read problem, because of write-read conflict again. These are the examples given to you to understand this